friends, this is Pavani, and here we can see next topic in Excel. And previous day we have stopped near date. So in number formatting, how to mention the date in your Excel, we have stopped. Now we can see from there. See, for example, I am mentioning the date here. For example, 20 May, okay, 2021. Okay, so this format, if you want to change, or else if you want to drag till 30, okay, if you want to do like that, place the cursor here and go to in number, okay, number option, select here, short date or long date, or else more number formats here. See, here we have different types of formats, means different types of number samples. If you want to give, here we can give in the sample. Here I am selecting the March, means this style if you want, select here, okay, May, okay, you just click and drag, we can see here, like this, okay, this is the number format, date format if you want. For example, if you want in another style, select here, means you want to change first date, month and year, or else if you want to change year, month, date like that, here we have different type. Select this, okay, like this, okay, just click and drag. We can see here different options. Again, if you want, same, select more number formats. With the day also, if you want to mention, select this, okay, Thursday. I can click and drag, it will change the previous one also. Okay, this is the date format. Understood? Okay. For example, 1st January 2020, okay, select here, short date, this is called short date, long date means it will mention the January, click and drag it, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, like this. Want to change the format, select here, format, which format you want to convert, you can convert into that format, select here, like this, or else like this, okay, like this, just click and drag it. This format we can see, this is the date format in your Excel, okay. And next we can see here styles. In styles options we have different types: conditional formatting, format as table, cell styles, okay. For this, if you want to do, first we want to prepare some data. Conditional formatting means here we have different types of options here. If you want to select greater than, less than, between, or else if you want to find any information in your data, so we can use with the help of conditional formatting. With the help of this conditional formatting, we can use the options. First, we want to prepare one data. For example, I want to prepare some employee table, okay. So here I am merging the cells. You know how to merge the cells, okay. Select here, select it, merge employee table, okay. This is the employee table. Employee number, employee name, okay, department. For example, next what we can do, salary, okay, just take any example, okay. Employee number 1, next 2, how to drag here, just select, click and drag it, okay. Next A, give the names here, okay, you can give it. Next, departments, which departments they belong. Okay. Okay, salary, give the salary here. this is some data. Want to apply colors, you can do here. Okay, bold, italic. Here we can select it. See here, just observe what I am doing. Here I want to set the table till E only. So what we want to do? Just merge the cells, unmerge it. Okay. This separate cell, separate cell. Till here only I want to merge. Select it, merge it. Okay, just select this color, keep it white. That's all. Okay, here it has been merged. If you want to do, select it, unmerge. Color we have applied, right? So here, no fill, that's all. And here we can see, here I have taken one table here. Okay, conditional formatting. In conditional formatting, we have different types of options, highlighted cell rules, top or data bits or total, it has been shown here. So here first option we can see in highlighted cells rules. In highlight cells rules means we need to find the greater than. For example, I need to select greater than 20,000, means above 20,000 salaries I need to select. So if you want to do like that, not only in this, you can select any data, product details or else student data. For example, in student data, if you want more than, greater than 80 marks or greater than 35 marks, if you want, just based on our information we can select a conditional formatting. For first, if you want to select this, before that we need to select the data here. Okay, select the data and go to conditional formatting. In highlighted cells rule, select greater than. Greater than, for example, I need greater than 30,000. Greater than 30,000. Okay, see here, color also it has been mentioned, red light red filled with dark red text. Okay, okay, see, the greater than 50,000 is here. We can see here, purchase only, the 50,000 only it has been highlighted. Okay, depends upon our selection. Just select the salary only. Will select a total area. Okay, just select it. Less than, if you want less than, I need less than 14,000. Just select 14,000. See, it has been mentioned. If you want to change the colors also, we can change it. Green fill. Okay, like this. Red border. See, okay. Yellow. It has been. See. Next. Between. Between, if you want. Between, I need 20 to 30, or else for 12 to 14 if you want, 12,000 to 14,000, 12 to 14,000, if you want 12 to 14,000. See here with red color, you can change these colors also. Okay, green fill like this, red border means red border, yellow fill. Okay, next we have seen, between we have seen. Next, equal to. Equal, if you want 50,000. Okay, till equal 50,000 if you want. Okay, like this. Why this 14, 15 has been highlighted? We have not removed the previous one. So if you want to do less than, okay, okay, like this. Now between if you want to select here, sorry, equal to 30,000. There is only one, or else you can select here 20,000. See how many 20,000s? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, like this. Okay, next option we can see text that contains. For example, I need only purchase department I need to highlight, or else only sales department I need to highlight. But here you will see that we have selected only salary. In salary we can't see the text, we can see the numbers, so we can't go for that. What we don't need to do before that, first select the total table. Okay, select the table, go to conditional formatting and select your text contains. I need to select only purchase. See, the only purchase text will be highlighted, depends upon your selection. If you select numbers, it selected the numbers only. Okay, names, letters means letters only. Next, same process here, greater than, less than, between, equal, text, date also. If you mention here date, it will be date also. For example, I'll mention here. Just select, click and drag. Okay, selecting the data here. I need the date 10th. For example, select here date occurring yesterday's. Okay, today, tomorrow, in last 7 days. Okay, if you want last 7 days, select here. Okay, that based upon the system date. So I'll change the date here to the date 17. Okay, just click and drag it. Okay, select it. See here, it has been highlighted. We have selected now, no, it is in that mode only. Select here date occurring yesterday means it has been shown yesterday's. For example, today has been will be shown here. Select it, date, it is in yesterday's only. Tomorrow, select here yellow. See, we can see here. Okay, tomorrow dates means the date also, if you want to highlight or if you want to keep any reminder with the different colors, we can select here. Okay, like this, red fit color. Here we have different types, duplicate values. If you want to delete the duplicate values, or if you want to find the duplicate values, means these duplicate values also we can select. For example, select the total table. Please select the total table. Here we can see duplicate values here. Just hello, all are the duplicate values. Sales we have duplicate, purchase, marketing, all see here. Okay, select here. Okay, depends upon our selection, we can select here. These are the duplicate. Okay, and here top bottom rules means top 10 items if you want to pick, or the according to your percentage if you want to pick, or else bottom, middle, whatever you prefer, selections. If you want to select from your table some more top items or bottom items if you want to need, just select here top bottom rules. Top items if you want, top items. just select, see here, we can observe light red color. See, these all are the top 9. Like this we can select according to our table. Okay, next here we can see data bars. For this table, if you want to apply the data bars, means which is high, which is low, which is medium, if you want to do that, just we can apply here data bar. Select here data bars. We have different options: gradient fill and solid fill. For example, here we have given the number, sorry, salary, right? For these salaries, if you want to apply the bars, data bars, select here. See here, we can see the difference. See, just coming to the original. See, select here, select here data bars. See, you can use. So if you want in styles, the gradient fill or solid fill, if you want, select here like this. Okay, and next, color scales. Color scales, you want to give apply the different colors to your data bars also, we can do here, here this one. Icons, if you want to give icons, means for high salary, it will be the high arrow, up arrow. For down, it will be the down arrow. Okay, that if you want to do, we can select this. Select here color scales. If you want color scales, icon sets, we can select here icon sets like this, right? Okay, based on our selection, we can select here. Clear, you have applied all these colors and all these arrows. If you want to clear, just clear it. Okay, and selected if you want to clear, or else from entire sheet if you want to clear, it has been cleared. This is the conditional formatting. New rule, if you want the same, whatever the options we have repeated, same options here we can see. Format only unit view or duplicate values may here. Okay, use a formula to determine which cells to format. These we can observe here. All this. So next, format as table. If you want to show your data as a in the form of table, just first select the table here, okay, and go to format as table. Select it here. See, we can see the dots rotating like. So where the cells we have started here, B28, it has been ended till E38. Just click on OK. It has been shown like a table. Okay, table means here we can see here employee name. If you want to select only for your required one, you can select that required one only, or else if you want only select all, you can select all. For example, I need only sales department. Okay, if you want to do that, select your department, and I'm deleting this purchase and marketing. Only I need the sales. Okay, only we can see the sales. This is nothing but format as table. Okay, all if you want, select here, select all. Okay, okay, based on our selection. And if you want to remove this table, see, whenever you insert the format as table, the another menu bar will be opened here, design. Okay, in this we can see number of designs, colors also we can mention here. So okay, if you want to delete the this form in a form of the table, if you want to remove it, convert to range. Okay, that's all. This is the format as table. Here we have different colors. If you have, see, it has been selected. Now if you want to do that, our table has been started from B29, but it here we can see here A29 also has been selected. So what you do, just place the cursor here, remove the A and select the B. Okay, and here remove this 27 and select 29. Okay, 29 to E38. Here we can see it. Just click the cancel. Select as format as table. B. Okay, table has been selected. So this is nothing but format as table. If you want to remove, Just go to design, convert to range. That's all. Insert. Come here and insert. Okay, this is the formatized table. Cell styles. If you want to change the cell styles also, we can change the cell styles. See, I have selected this. For example, I need this. Want to change only particular cells? Select here. I want to change the cell styles. Or headings, if you want to change, select the only headings, cell styles, select here, headings, like this. We can do it. Okay? Heading 4, heading 3, all this. This is the conditional formatting, formatized table and cell styles. Okay? And next we can see here, insert, delete, format. Insert, delete and format. If you want to insert the cells or insert the rows, columns or delete the rows and columns, we have seen in first class how to insert rows and how to insert the columns. Same, we can see the options here. In cells, we can see insert cells, insert sheet rows, insert sheet columns and insert sheet. Okay? Delete also, same process. When you will insert, in that process only we can delete also. For example, I want to insert the sheet. So how to insert the sheet here? From here also we can insert the sheet and select here, insert the sheet. Okay, select here, plus symbol, insert it. And here, if you want to delete, we can delete. Cells, if you want to delete. For example, I want to delete the cells here. Sheet 1. To delete the left side if you want to delete, or entire row if you want to delete, cells upside if you want to delete. Okay, cells up. Okay, see, it has been deleted. Format, row height, if you want to increase the row height, column width, or else hide, unhide, or else if you want to rename the sheet, we have learned in first class how to hide and unhide, how to copy and how to rename the sheet, how to apply the tab colors and how to protect the sheets. Okay, particular sheet if you want to give the password, we can do that. And if you want to apply here editing, if you want to edit your data in editing formation, we want to edit. And if you want to give the total sum, you want, for example, I want to add all this. See, I want placing here anywhere you place the cursor, is equal to sum, open bracket, and select all this. Okay, and close the bracket, enter. This is the formula we have seen. Or else if you want to edit, edit means, for example, I want to find some particular data. For find, what is the shortcut key? Control plus F. I need to find the purchase. Purchase, if you want to find, just type there, enter. See, cursor will move to here, purchase. Next, wherever the next purchase is there, it will find next. See here. Again, find next. See, wherever the purchase is there, if you select here find next, it will move to there, only to purchase, not to another word. Okay, next, if you want to replace, means I want to replace the purchase to sales, want to do that. So what is the shortcut key? Control H, not Control R, Control H. I want to replace this purchase for through as sales. For example, here, not here purchase, I am writing here sales. Whatever the word you want to replace, just write, select here find what, okay, and replace with, okay, with which word you want to replace. Sales, I want to replace as purchase. Sales, find sales and replace, first find the sale. See here, sale, I want to replace this as purchase. Okay, here we can see replace. See, it has been replaced. It is asking here if you want to replace all. Replace all means wherever the sales it has been mentioned, the sales want to replace to only purchase, or total we want to replace the total sales. Yes, replace all means replace all. See, we made two replacements. Now you see the sales, we can find the sales here. Control F, find the sales. No, we can't find, why? Because we have replaced sales to purchase. So this is the find and replace. Go to. You want to go. Control plus G. For example, I need to go for the reference if you want to do. go to D34. See, like this. Here we have some shortcut keys, Control plus F to find, Control plus G to go to, Control plus H to replace, and we have done the total also here. Okay, this is the editing cells and styles here. To clear it, clear all. Okay, so whatever you have done, it has been cleared. Okay, thank you. Next, we can see insert. Next class, we can see about insert.